In this video, we will consider the importance of a whole system approach and then look at how data and technology can improve the quality of remote learning, support learners through assistive technologies, and provide learning credentials that can increase the future opportunities for data and technology to effectively increase equity and reduce disparities. It is important first and foremost that a whole system approach is taken. What does this mean? It means that all entities must be involved. This includes all the relevant ministry that collect, analyze, and monitor data on learners where a culture of data sharing should be encouraged. It also includes all educational institutions, local education authorities, and health centers. Together, they can work to enhance equity in education by ensuring a view of the big picture as well as all socio-economic factors that are involved, especially when it comes to the vulnerable groups. Collaboration needs to be both horizontal across sectors, but also vertical between national decision-making bodies and individual schools and local communities. Together, they will be stronger to bring implement innovations and technologies that will help to reduce disparities and increase equitable education for all. Remote learning. The COVID-19 pandemic caused a widening gap in learning outcomes and increased the digital divide. We have already looked at some of the solutions, but let's look more specifically on how data and technology can help to reduce disparities. We saw in the previous video how technological innovations can help to increase connectivity to remote areas with limited or no internet connectivity, and Vietnam of using machine learning to forecast potential dropouts. Machine learning can also help better serve remote learners by following their learning progress and identifying when and how they're struggling in order to better support their needs. According to the European Investment Bank, big data can not only help track learner performance, but early warning systems can also be used to alert schools if there's a risk of dropout or falling behind, as well as project future learning outcomes by using student information and national test scores. World Bank states that EdTech was the key to keep up learning throughout the pandemic, and they have developed EdTech Toolkit for remote learning to support policymakers and researchers in using different learning modalities and technologies available for remote, hybrid, and low-resource environments. UNESCO's COVID-19 Response Toolkit is another example aimed at supporting education system leaders in their remote learning strategy while considering technological resources. At the same time, we also shouldn't discard low-tech modalities that are helping to increase equity through remote learning, such as SMS, radio, and television. In Botswana, an experiment by the National Bureau of Economic Research found great success in sending SMS messages and phone calls to parents to help them support their child's learning at home. The experiments not only showed an increase in learning outcomes, but also highlighted the important role that parents can play in improving their child's learning and enrollment to schools. As the ecosystem of education startups continue to flourish, there is no doubt that technologies will continue to offer new educational opportunities that are more accessible and affordable than ever before. Assistive technologies. Assistive technologies play a powerful role in making sure that learners from all backgrounds and abilities have equitable access to education. Assistive technologies can also help to support students with impairments such as mobility, sight, hearing, learning, and socializing, as well as chronic health conditions. For learners with reading or vision impairments, Assistive technologies can include text-to-speech software or tablets with magnifier, while hearing aids can support learners with hearing impairments. They can include innovative functions such as speech recognition, refreshable braille displays, facial recognition and eye tracking, and much more. They can help learners with a learning disability to keep up with traditional curriculum or help a learner with a physical disability or conditions such as ADHD or autism. They can also provide language learning support to linguistic minorities or migrants who have just joined the education system where the language of instruction is not their own. However, the distribution of assistive technologies is not always sufficient to ensure equity, especially in developing countries. According to the WHO and UNICEF, access to assistive technologies may be reaching only 3% of people in low and middle income countries. A law enacted in the Philippines in 2022 mandates all schools to ensure inclusive education for learners with disabilities. It includes the provision of assistive devices as well as facilities and infrastructure to be considered in budgets and resource allocation. Another example is found in the Learn Big initiative in Thailand, an application that supports migrants with basic literacy and numeracy skills and has materials in Myanmar, Thai, Malay, and minority languages to ensure that it can adapt to learners' mother tongue. Learning credentials. As we increasingly look to online learning to continue learning throughout life with the support of online trainings, courses, and programs, there's also a need to recognize that they acquire knowledge in some shape or form. A number of innovations are already available to help make this a reality, including micro-credential, learning passports, and credit banks. Micro-credentials allow for the recognition and certification of learning outcomes obtained in short-term study. According to the European Commission, they support an effective culture of lifelong learning as a flexible and targeted way to obtain knowledge, skills, and competencies for personal and professional development. In this sense, they have great potential to improve opportunities for those that are disadvantaged and vulnerable by broadening potential educational and job opportunities. A well-known example of micro-credentials provider is Coursera, the online learning platform that offers countless short courses from universities around the world. Here, learners have an option to pay a small fee for an official certificate to become accredited. A more specific example is Kiron Campus, an online course program designed to empower refugees by improving language skills, prepare them for higher education, and for the labor market through providing high-quality learning opportunities. Learning Passport is an online, offline, and mobile platform and educational model delivered by UNICEF and Microsoft to provide continuous access to quality education. The platform is flexible and adaptable, meaning that countries can easily use it as the national learning management system. Not only does the platform use local and contextualized content, but it also prioritizes deployment in locations with little or no internet connectivity. Credit banks are key to lifelong learning opportunities, especially for those who may have studied outside of the formal system and who are likely to be from a vulnerable group. The concept of academic credit banking is already used in the United States, Australia, and the Republic of Korea, and ensures regulating and facilitating the transfer of learning ranging from certificates, non-degree programs, and training courses. In Thailand's Thak province, a credit bank system is being used for vocational institutions as a way to transfer knowledge and experience. In these experiments, the following four benefits were found. First, enhanced learning opportunities for those whose studies has been discontinued. Second, offered working adults the chance to substitute work experience for curriculum credits to pursue professional development opportunities. Third, created an innovative and collaborative network of institutions. Fourth, provided a prototype for a credit bank system that could be used nationwide. As we can see, data and technology have a key role to play in making education more equitable in the future. Remote learning is here to stay and require us to reach learners in all contexts, including the most vulnerable, and offering them the possibility of receiving as high quality learning experiences and outcome as learners who are most privileged. Assistive technologies are showing us what is possible to support learners who are in need of additional support, and learning credentials are opening a world of possibilities to learners that may not have had before.